Good morning, dear students. I hope you all are fine. So, this is the second part of your 7th chapter. In first portion, we have covered your reading of the chapter, and in this portion, we are going to solve your vocabulary portion and grammatical portion. So, this is the second part. So, moving to the vocabulary portion. So, here they have given you a paragraph, and this paragraph is having some kind of fill-ups, and you have to fill these blanks by choosing, you can say, correct word from the, or the most appropriate word from the given box. So just read this paragraph carefully. I am reading it for you. You have to have a lot of stamina to be a top class mountaineer, and dash to Mount Everest is a mammoth task. So, and dash to Mount Everest means to say they are talking about any kind of journey, and as we have studied from the chapter that a journey with a special target, that is called your expedition. So the word here is expedition, and expedition to Mount Everest is a mammoth task. And then next, the dash need focus and tremendous willpower. So the mountaineers need focus and tremendous willpower. Climbing the world's dash mountain is a great dash. So climbing the world's highest mountain is a great challenge because there is not enough oxygen in the atmosphere of the peaks. The amazing experience of those who have climbed a dash inspired the imagination of other people who aspire to become mountaineer, and they try their dash. So the amazing experience of those who have climbed the dash inspire who have climbed the peak. They have given you a word peak. So who have climbed the peak? Peak means to say top part of the mountain. Inspired the imagination of other people who aspire to become mountaineers, and they try their luck. So this is all about here, this passage. You have to choose most appropriate words from the given box. And then next, B2 exercise. Read the following sentences. Deduce the meaning of the highlighted words from the context. To choose the correct synonyms from the options. So students, they have given you one sentence, and these two words that are, you can say, highlighted, they are given in the sentences, and they have given you four options of the synonyms in front of these words. Synonym means to the words that are having same meanings. So I am reading first for you. The sentence is, the winning team has dedication. It has a core of veteran players who set the standards. They will not accept defeat. So the word, two words are dedication and veteran. So dedication means to say some kind of, you can say, courage or some kind of commitment towards any particular field to be successful in that field. So the word that is synonym to dedication is commitment. And similarly, veteran means to say a person who is playing a game for so many years, or any of the experienced person. So veteran, the word veteran is having the similar meaning as that of your word that is expert. So this is about your first two, that is dedication means commitment, and veteran means to say an expert. So second sentence they have given, the finish line is sometimes merely a symbol of victory. All sorts of personal triumphs takes place before that point, and the outcome of the race may actually be decided long before the end. So the word triumph and outcome. So the word triumph means to say victory. Okay, so word triumphs here given, so you have to choose victories, and outcome means to say result. Result of anything is called outcome. So in the similar way, you have to read all these sentences and then check the words given that are in the italic form, and then you have to find the word of the similar meaning. You may Google it also, so just try to find the correct similar meaning word from the given four words. So try this. Then moving to the next page, now again, use the words given in the B2 and fill in the blanks. Use the hints given in the breaks. So as we have done with the words in the B2 section, now what you have to do, you have to choose out of those words and fill in these blanks. So first one is, the championship proved to be a personal dash for their coach. A great success gained with lot of skill or effort. So great success is called victory or triumph. So The championship proved to be a personal triumph for their coach. Triumph means to say victory. Great success means to say victory or triumph. So they have given you hints along with these blanks, and also you have to choose a word that we have already done in your B2 section. So triumph is the most suitable word here. So first fill up is triumph. Then next is the coach was confident of a successful dash of their relentless practice. So here the word is outcome, situation existing at the end of an activity. They have given you the hint, and situation existing at the end of an activity means to say result of something, and result means to say outcome. So the second fill up is outcome. So in the similar way, you have to read all these blanks and then try to fill with the most suitable word as given in your B2 section. So then comes your grammar portion, and their topic is subject verb conquered. So as we have already done this topic in your 7th class also, so this is very easy topic. Subject verb conquered means to say the agreement between subject and verb. So if the subject is singular, we will use singular verb. If the subject is plural, we will use plural verbs, and helping verbs also, and the words that are verbs that are also. So singular verbs contain s or es, as we all know that, and plural verbs are simple words like plays is a singular verb and play is a plural verb. And as we all know that helping verbs like is, was, has, these are singular verbs, and are, were, have, all these words are plural form of helping verbs. So we have to be careful while using verbs. We have to check the agreement between subject and verb. If the subject is singular, then we have to use singular verb. If the subject is plural, then we have to use plural verb. So they have given you some example. First one is Sanjay enjoys adventure. So Sanjay is a single person. Sanjay is the name of one boy or one person. So it's a single subject, singular subject. That is why we are using enjoys. Enjoys, s is a verb, is having s along with it. It means it is a singular verb. Remember that verb which is having s or es, that is called singular verb, or without s or es, that verb is called plural verb. So Sanjay enjoys adventure. He is climbing up the hill. He ke saath hum are nahi use karenge because he is used for single person. So he is climbing up the hill. Then mountaineering is his hobby. So mountaineering means to say single cheez ki baat ki ja rahi hai ki chadhai pe chadna uski kya hai, hobby hai. So iske saath bhi hum kya use karenge, is, that is your singular verb. Similarly, they have given you the examples of plural subjects like Sanjay and Anil. Now Sanjay and Anil means to say we are talking about two persons. So subject here is plural, so therefore we will use your plural verb, that is are. Sanjay and Anil are classmates. Then we like paragliding. So we is a, you can say we is a plural subject. That is why we have used plural verb like. We are not writing like likes. So if the subject is singular, I ke saath hota, to I likes paragliding aana tha. If we are using plural subject, that is we, then we have to use like. So we like paragliding. Then is mountaineers are brave people. So mountaineers likha hua hai, that is why the subject is plural. That is why we are using are, because are is a plural form of verb. So in this way, you have to be careful while using subject along with that verb. Then there are some more rules are given for the subject verb agreement or subject verb conquered. So first is, when the subject is singular, the verb is singular, as we have already done. For example, Harish is singular subject, so Harish writes poems. Then next is, this is a beautiful poem. So this means we are talking about single thing. If we are talking about more than one thing, we use these. So if we are using this, this is a singular subject, so we are using singular verb, that is. So this is a beautiful poem. So second rule is that when the subject is plural, verb is plural. So Harish and Shweta write poems. So Harish and Shweta, now two people, we are talking about two people. So subject is plural, that is why we are using plural form of verb, that is write. So next is, they are poets. Again, they means to say we are talking about more than one person. So they can be two person, three person, or any number of person. So they means to say plural subject, and therefore we have to use are, because are is a plural form of verb. So they are poets. So then third rule is that a singular subject with attached phrases introduced by with, like, as well as is followed by singular verb. So if the subjects are singular and they are containing the words like with, like, or as well as, these words are present in the sentence, then we use singular verb. For example, Zohra with several others was disqualified. So no doubt they are talking about several other people also, but the word here is used as with. So Zohra, basically we are talking about Zohra here. So Zohra with several other was disqualified. So here we have to use, because the word with is present in the sentence, that is why we have to use a singular subject according to the rule. So we are using here was, not were. Then Tom as well as Sleem rises early in the morning. So the word as well as, because of as well as, we are using rises. Rises means to say singular form of verb. If they have written Tom and Sleem, then we have to use rise, because Tom and Sleem collectively forms a plural form of subject. So that is why we have to use here plural form of verb. So basically here they are using the word as well as, so they are talking about you can say singular subject. So that is why we have to use singular form of verb, that is rises. Then comes, here are some words and expressions that are followed by singular verbs. So if you find any of these words in the sentence, like each of, one of, neither of, every one of, then you have to choose you have to always use singular verbs. Each, any, none, anyone, anybody, everyone, everybody, nobody, all these words contain, all these words always followed by singular verbs. So first is, each of my friends has a pet. So each of is written, that is why we are using has, not have. So along with these kind of words, we have to always use your singular verb. So similarly, neither of the thieves was caught. So was, we are using was. Why? Because neither of is already given in the sentence. Similarly, anybody is welcome here. So anybody is given, we are not allowed to use are here. We have to use is, because anybody is given and it is given in the rule. If these kind of words are here, if these kind of words are there in the sentence, then you have to use singular verb. So then next rule is that when two subjects are connected by and, the verb is plural. So as I have already given you this example, that if two subjects are connected by and conjunction, then you have to use the verb in plural form. For example, Tanu and Shireen are great friends. So here Tanu and Shireen, and is given in between two people, so we have to use are. That is plural form of verb. Here we can't use is. Similarly, Azhar and his wife like boating. So we are using here like, because and is given. So like, we are using like, not likes. So in the similar way, next example is Mangalore and Shimoga are in Karnataka. So we are using are here. So in this way, we have to do like this. Again, they have given Tanu and her friends play here after school. Azhar and the waitress of the restaurant were standing in the hallway. So in the similar way, whenever you are using and between two singular subjects, you have to use plural form of verb. Okay, then your friends and my cousins have joined the club means two plural subjects connected by and. Even then you have to use plural form of verb. So these rules are very important. So take a reading of all these rules very carefully. Then when two singular subjects are connected by either or, neither nor, or simply by or, then you have to use singular form of verb. So in case of as well as also, or in case of either or, neither nor, or simply or is given, then you have to use singular form of verb along with those subjects. So for example, either Naren or Sumit is right. So here either or is given between Naren and Sumit, so that is why we are using singular form of verb, that is. Then neither the minister nor the police chief has any answer. So neither the minister nor the police chief has any answer. Again, neither nor is given in the sentence, so that is why we are using has, not have. We have to use singular form of verb in case of either or, neither nor, these kind of words. So then comes your seventh rule, that is plural subject connected by either or, neither nor, simply or will have a plural verb. So I earlier in sixth rule we were talking about singular subjects that are connected by either or. If the subjects are singular and they are connected by either or, then we have to use singular form of verb. But if the subjects are plural and then they are connected by either or, neither nor, then we have to use plural form of verb. For example, neither the boys nor the girls. Now boys means to say a number of boys, girls means to say a number of girls. We are not talking about single person. So here subject is plural, neither the boys nor the girls have written the correct answer. So we have to use have here, because have is the, you can say, plural form of verb. So because subject here was here in the plural form, we are talking about number of boys, we are talking about number of girls. So that is why we have to use plural form of verb here. So neither the boys nor the girls have written the correct answer. So in this way, similarly, next is neither the laborers nor the farmers were happy with the money they got. Okay, so moving to the next page now. So next is when the subject is a collective noun, for example, any crowd, team, government. So these are the single words, are singular, but actually they contain lot many people in them. For example, team. So cricket team, as we all know, cricket team includes 11 players. So we can use either singular or plural verb depending upon the meaning we want to convey. So you can use either singular verb or plural verb according to the meaning of your sentence or according to whatever you want to convey in your sentence. For example, the team needs motivation. So here we are considering the team as one person, because collectively team is one. So that is why it is used a singular form of verb, that is needs. So team needs motivation. In the second example, the team are celebrating their victory, means all the people belonging to team are celebrating their victory. So here team means to say plural, you can say team is considered as a plural. So that is why we are using are. So in the similar way, next is ninth rule, last rule is that sometimes the verb agree with the plural noun or pronoun that precedes it rather than with the actual subjects in the examples like these. So these are some special examples. None of the guests take sugar in their tea. So earlier we were using that, none of or any of these words are present, then we have to use singular form of a verb. But here these are some special example where despite of those kind of words, you have to use plural verbs. So read these examples carefully. Then comes your exercise. First one is Mona and Harpreet dash cousins. So students, what could be the answer of this fill up? Mona and Harpreet dash cousins. So as we have done that, if the subjects, two singular subjects are connected with the conjunction and we have to use plural form of verb, that is are. Here we use are. Mona and Harpreet are cousins. So next is one of the rooms dash painted in pink. So one of the room is painted, because we have already discussed that if the words like one of, none of, any of these kind of words are given, then we have to use singular form of verb. So similarly, try all these fill ups. Then again, C2 section is also related to this, your subject verb conquered. Here they have given you verbs and you have to choose correct verb. For example, first one is that neither he nor she dash to go. So the subject he and she, as we all know, subject is singular. And second thing is that they are using neither nor. So we have already done that if the subjects are singular and the words neither nor, either or simply or is used, then we have to always use singular form of a verb. So the correct answer will be wants. So neither he nor she wants to go. So similarly, second is James as well as Neha dash the evening prayer. So again, if as well as is given, then again we have to use singular form of verb. So correct answer will be attends. James as well as Neha attends the evening prayer. Okay. So then third is every little child dash a nice toy. So every little child, again these kind of words is also, we have already discussed, these kind of words always contain or always preceded by your singular verb. So every little child deserves a nice toy. Okay, so in the similar way, students just try to solve all these fill-ups. Then comes your listening and speaking part. So in listening part, what you have to do, again as I have already told you, that I will send your listening audio along with your answer key, and you have to listen that audio properly, carefully. You can listen that audio 2 times also. So just listen that audio. Then there is a talking, there is 2 schoolboys talking about a race in that audio. So you have to listen their conversation carefully, and then you have to fill in the blanks or true false or whatever is given. On the basis of that, you have to solve these things. So for example, that the boy was in dash, it was his first race, true or false. So firstly listen that audio, then you will be able to solve this listening part. Okay, so this is very easy, you can easily do this. Next, moving to the next page now. So then speaking part. So read the dialogues given below between 2 sportsperson. Practice it with your partner. So this is a conversation given between 2 people. So this is your speaking part. You can try with your siblings, with your cousins also. So just try to have a conversation like 2 sportspersons. Okay. Then comes your writing section. So what is given in this writing section? They are talking about newspaper articles. So what is newspaper articles? As we read newspaper, we came to know that about so many things, like about different types of education, or formal education, informal education, or you can say the kind of environment these days, or so many current issues are given in the newspaper. So those kind of writing pieces are called articles actually. So article present information on a variety of themes, a description of a place, it could be a description of any place, event or person. So description of place means to say there can be an article like on Taj Mahal in Agra. So that can be a description of a place, or event or any person. That information can be regarding to any event like sports event or any kind of function. So expressing one's opinion on some issue of social interest, arguing in favor or against a statement. So anything could be given in that newspaper article. And so for writing the newspaper article, what you have to be careful about, the things you have to be careful. First one is, the heading of an article should be interesting and eye-catching. You must give a proper heading to your speech or your article. Next one is the byline. The name of the writer comes after the heading. After the heading, you have to write your name, means the name of the writer. Then the opening paragraph should state the central theme and arouse interest. So the first paragraph, the starting paragraph, must be written in such a way that it must conclude, or it must show or throw light upon the things that you are going to convey through your articles, and it must arouse the interest between the reader, among the readers. Okay, then the main paragraph will develop the theme. In main paragraph, you have to write the theme of your article, whatever you are writing. Then discuss opposing side of an issue and show why your view is valid. Present argument in a logical, coherent and convincing fashion. Mention the future course of action. Okay, then conclude by offering suggestions to solve problem or change things for the better. And in the end, you have to give suggestions. For example, you are writing on the deteriorating condition of environment. So at the end of the article, you have to suggest some suggestion, or suggest some you can say ideas to prevent that. So what you have to do here, write a newspaper article about world population based upon the statistics given. So for dear students, every year 11th July is celebrated as World Population Day, and they have given you some data regarding to population of the world. So the estimated current population in the world in July 2017 was here 7.5 billion. So the population in India in July 2017 was 1.3 billion about, and India is the second country in the world after China to cross 1 billion mark. So they have given you data for so many countries here. About their population, first one is China, then comes India, then United States is there. So next, what you have to do, you have to write an article about population, about rising population. So population clock ticking away. This is the title of your article and they have started the article. So you have to add more lines into this article. At the end, you have to give some suggestions also to control the population, to control the population explosion. So in this way, this is about your chapter, that is 7th chapter. So I hope you have enjoyed it. Thanks for listening and have a nice day.